Hello and welcome to Education at SSBJ online video tutorials. We are in chapter number 15 of class 8th, Some Natural Phenomena. We have already studied in this chapter about the structure of atom. Let me write here, structure of atom in brief, not in detail. And why did we study this? Because in the previous video, during the start of this lesson, we had conducted some demonstrations. For example, when the thermocol balls are brought near a plastic pen, okay, brought near a plastic pen which is rubbed, by polythene paper. And then we saw these thermocol balls started moving towards this plastic pen. And then we have conducted an experiment that when you connect a positive and negative of 12 volt battery, and that gave a spark. Then we thought of relating this towards a natural phenomena called lightning. Right? And to understand lightning, we thought that we have to study structure of atom. And in this structure of atom, we have learned that atom contains proton, neutron in the center, which is called nucleus. And electrons are moving around the nucleus. This is the structure, brief structure of atom. And we have studied that protons have got a kind of charge, electric charge. A charge is a force experienced by that particle. Protons are positive in nature, we call that as positive, and electrons, these are the electrons which are negative in nature, and neutrons are neutral. Right? So these are our understanding. And very important point to be noted here, that every atom contains generally same number of protons and electrons, even the neutrons. Okay, that means they contain same number of positive and negative charges. If an element contains three protons, it will have three electrons and three neutrons. And that's why what happens, the 3 plus and 3 minus gets cancelled and the total charge becomes 0. Right? So far we have understood this much. So please remember, this much of information is required to understand the process of lightning. Right? So keeping in our mind these demonstrations, we'll go ahead now. Let us take some objects. Let's take a kind of a rod, you know. You can even think that this is a plastic rod, plastic, okay, object. And this is a kind of another material. You can take it as a cloth, right? So both are neutral. And can you tell me why are they neutral? Again, if go back to the structure of atom, same number of protons, number of protons will be equal to number of electrons. In short, I am writing, okay, please try to understand. So how many positive charges are there in each of them, so many negative charges will be there. Okay, now let us count why it is neutral and why these substances are, materials are neutral. So let me count here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, right, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Did I leave anywhere? Okay, no. So we have 12 plus here. Now let me check here. 1, 2, right, here 3, 4 and 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. 12 minus, right? So we have 12 plus and 12 minus, because every matter consists of atom, and every atom consists of equal number of protons and neutrons, and therefore the matter also, or this material also, consists of, okay, same number of protons. That is, we have taken just an example here. It need not be always 12 plus. Just to be familiar with that, it will be in millions. Okay, more than that, we cannot even think of a tip of a needle will have millions of atoms and so many electrons and protons. Just you can think of that. Okay, just to have a kind of situation here, to understand what is this charging phenomenon, what we call a charging. We have created a situation here. Now in the same way, go for this, right? This is also a neutral. And why it is a neutral? Let me check how many. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 protons are there. That means 10 positive and 1 negative number. How many negative symbols are there? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Okay. So 10 minus are there. Again it's a neutral. Right? Okay. So these two are neutral in nature because they have got same number of charges, positive as well as negative. So this is the first conclusion now. This is same with any of the two objects which is there in nature. Until and unless we rub them each other. Rubbing. Okay. So when we rub this, both the materials, each other, what happens? Some of the negative charges will move. Either it may move from here to here or here to here. It depends on the nature of this material. But remember, why negative charges will move? Because in an atom, positive charges and neutrons are firmly packed. They don't easily move. But the electrons are already moving. Okay? They are moving and then they are little far away. So they tend to move outside. So it is the electrons, that the negative charge, when they are in the form of solid, they tend to move from one end to another. Now consider that we have rubbed each of these materials properly. And as I said, what will happen is some of the negative charges will move either from one material to another material. Okay, so what happens is, let us assume that some negative charges moved from one end to another end. Now let us check how many electrons and protons are there in each of these material, right? So in this material we have number of protons here. Protons are positively charged. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 are there. So 12 positive charges are there. And how many electrons are there now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 are there. So 9 electrons are there. So I'll write here minus 9. So these are protons and electrons. So please remember here, okay, this situation we have made to understand how the things get charged. Understood? Don't go by the number of protons and neutrons. I have taken few number of protons and neutrons here. Right, but actually in practical it is not only few, 10 or 12. And now let us check the charge of this. Earlier it was having 12 plus and 12 minus, the charge was 0. Correct? Now we have plus 3. See, plus 12 and minus 3. Plus 3 means what? It's a positive. So, is this material neutral now? No. It's a material which is positively charged. So, what is the charge of this material now? Positive charge. In the same way, go for this material now. How many protons are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 protons are there. 10 protons. That means plus 10. Okay. Then how many electrons? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and so this is 11, 12, and 13. Because you know how many extra electrons have come? 3 have come from this end to this end, plus minus 3, that is 3 electrons have come. Otherwise this would have become this. So earlier 10 was that, now it's a 13, right? Minus 13. So what are these minus 13? Electrons. So now tell me the total charge of this. Plus 10 minus 13 will be equal to minus 3, right? So which charge is more here? Negative charge is more here, and therefore it is referred as negatively charged. Right? So now you have made two materials which are positively charged as well as negatively charged in nature. And then we say that these are charged bodies. What we call it as? Charged bodies. Now, how do you charge the bodies? Just by rubbing. Right? Same thing happens in the atmosphere. Clouds get rubbed. There will be a breeze. Okay? Water vapor, water molecules get rubbed each other. And when they rub, they become charged. Now, I hope you have understood what do you mean by getting charged in physics. These are electric charges. Okay, these are called electric charges. Now, please recall our experiment. Right? We have taken few thermocol balls. Right? Let's say, and these thermocol balls are not rubbed, right? They are neutral in nature. Please recall the experiment which we have conducted. Please go through the video, right? So that means they have equal number of protons and electrons. Let us assume that, okay, since I cannot draw many of the positive and negative sign, so I'll draw only 2 plus and 2 negative signs, so that to show that it's a neutral. And then we have taken a pen. Okay, it's a kind of plastic. Okay, and then polythene paper we have taken and we have rubbed it. Okay, rubbing is done. So as I said, there must have been some movement of charges which are from either this end to this end. Let us suppose that some electrons have, okay, some electrons have come from this plastic to here, okay, some electrons have come here. So most of the electrons, they are, let us show here. So what do you mean by electrons? They are negative charges, isn't it? And let us assume that this has become completely of negative charge. So we can write here as negatively charged pen, right? And why did that charge came here? Because of rubbing. We have assumed some electrons have come here, okay? These are negative charges. Now you are bringing this negative charge to towards the thermocol. The moment you bring the negative charge towards the thermocol, okay, there are already negative charges which are there. They will move away. Okay, they will move away. So the stage will be like, you know, they will move on one side and remaining will be positive. So you are bringing a negatively charged pen towards this. So which of the charges are nearby now? Positive charge. And negative charges have moved away, not outside, at other end of the object. So thereby you will find sometimes attraction and repulsion depends on the nature of the material, because like charges repel, and unlike charges attract. Okay, this is the reason. That means you bring an object which is negatively charged near to the object which is positively charged, they will attract because they are unlike charges. And how can we charge them? We have to rub them properly. Rubbing. Okay? So this is what is about charging. Right? And so attraction and repulsion is possible because of the charges. Okay? I'll repeat. And why are the charges? Because we have rubbed them and few of the electrons have been moved from one end to another end. Right? Now I hope you have understood why that plastic pen could attract. Right? Because plastic pen was rubbed with another material. So plastic became charged. Now we shall, in the next video, connect this information and understand lightning. Okay. Thank you very much.